We're back discussing terrorism and the return of the president from vacation. In Clute, Texas, is Congressman Ron Paul, Republican of Texas. He's a member of House Foreign Affairs Committee and was a candidate for his party's presidential nomination in 2008. Here in L.A. is Tanya Acker, political analyst and contributor to the HuffingtonPost.com. In D.C. is Peter Beinart, senior political writer for the Daily Beast, professor, City University of New York, and author of The Good Fight, Why Liberals and Only Liberals Can Win the War on Terror and Make America Great Again. And in New York is Andrea Tantaros, conservative columnist and Republican strategist. Well, Congressman Paul, how's the president dealt with this terror thing, do you think?
Well, I think in about the way I would expect, nothing too special, nothing bad, nothing real good, because I don't think we're getting to the bottom of it, because everybody's talking about a war on terrorism, and a lot of us have come to the conclusion that terrorism is a tactic, and you can't declare war on a tactic, and just what are we doing? And too often what I hear Obama saying is that we have to expand the war. You know, we're in a lot of countries over there, and we're using these drones to drop them on people, and to me that's an act of war. And we've done that in Yemen, and we've done it in Pakistan, we've done it just this week. And I think that's the real issue. How far do we expand this when the declaration of war against terrorism and radical Islam, I mean, it's endless. It has to be more narrowed down. We have to have a target and understand what's going on. We have to try to understand why there are people who are incentivized to come here and try to do us harm. And I don't think we're doing that. I don't think they did it in the Bush administration. I don't think they're doing it in this administration either.
Tanya, the president has talked about accountability at all levels. How's he doing?
Well, look, I think that Congressman Paul actually just raised a number of very, very good points, because when we're talking about this war on terror, we do have to be more precise about what it is we're doing. Yemen is a very different place from Iraq, which is a very different place from Afghanistan. And until we start to get our handle on some of these internal problems and why these situations are so combustible, then we're going to simply be declaring war on a tactic without any resolution. So I think that in terms of what you're seeing in the president's approach in Yemen is, when we can't simply drop bombs, we can't simply launch missile strikes. We do have to look at some of the situation on the ground. It's a civil war.
Andrea,
and we need to give the president of Yemen some cover.
Andrea, do we do enough here of cause and effect?
Yeah, I mean, I just want to go back to what Ron Paul and Tanya said. To say that we need to take time to get a better understanding that this is a civil war, that is completely the rhetoric that we can't hear right now. And I'll tell you why, Larry. A man almost blew up 300 people on an airplane. Now, they seem to know that they're at war with us by declaring jihad. We don't seem to be acknowledging that, at least in our administration now. And we have an opportunity to learn from the mistakes that the Bush administration made. Look, Obama bungled the initial response. We know that. Especially, you'd think he would have learned from George Bush's visual on the golf course, but he didn't. And the biggest mistake was, but he can fix it, the biggest mistake was trying this guy as, not trying him as an enemy combatant. That was a missed opportunity. Now we're in negotiations with him, as Brennan said. And he has an opportunity to not send these 40 Yemeni men back to Yemen. That would be the best thing he could do, to immediately stop the threat, because we cannot perpetually be on duty. We have to strike them. It's futile that we strike them before they can even craft these attacks.
Before I get a break, I got to take. Peter, what are your thoughts?
But what does it mean by to strike them? You know, if we kill a couple terrorists and we kill hundreds or thousands of innocent people who then become sympathetic to terrorism, that's why I think ultimately war, at least in the way that the other guest is suggesting, it doesn't really make any sense. This is not primarily a military conflict. It's primarily an ideological and economic conflict, and the military should be used sparingly.
And we're going to take a break and come right back. Dick Cheney's been on the attack over President Obama's handling of terrorism. The White House strikes back in 60 seconds. Former Vice President Dick Cheney has been harshly critical of President Obama's handling of national security issues for months. In the aftermath of the thwarted Christmas Day bombing attack, he accused the president of trying to pretend that the United States is not at war with terrorists. Deputy National Security Advisor John Brennan countered Cheney's comments during a series of Sunday talk shows. Watch.
Either the vice president is willfully mischaracterizing this president's position, both in terms of the language he uses and the actions he's taken, or he's ignorant of the facts. And in either case, it doesn't speak well of what the vice president is doing. The clear evidence is that this president has been very, very strong. In his inaugural address, he said, "We're at war with this international network of terrorists."
Congressman Paul, what about, he's in your party, what about Dick Cheney's complaints?
Well, I think he had his 8 years, and he's caused a lot of trouble for our country, and he perpetuated a war in Iraq that was unnecessary and wrong-headed. So I would say that it'd be best he not be so critical right now. But I'm still not only critical of that policy, I think the policy remains the same, and we've heard it on the show tonight already. They are going to attack us, and they've declared war against us, and it's always they and them. But who are they? You know, after 9/11, 14 or 15 of the terrorists came from Saudi Arabia. I mean, we didn't attack Saudi Arabia, we attacked Iraq. So it doesn't make sense. And those individuals were trained or at least planned in Germany and Spain. Some of them even got trained here in the United States. So you don't declare war against these countries and say that we have to go in and start bombing Pakistan and bombing Afghanistan and bombing Yemen. They happen to be there, that's true, but they're there because we stimulate them. We've fallen into the hands of Osama bin Laden by us doing there and causing people to get so angry. It helps his recruiting efforts. He has written about this. He has said this. He says, "I want the Americans to come over here and get bogged down, bankrupt their countries, and besides, it will help my recruiting efforts." And we're doing exactly what he had planned.
We'll be right back, by the way, tomorrow night. Michael Chertoff, the former Secretary of Homeland Security, will be with us. Will the renewed focus on terror shift attention away from health care reform and other issues? Talk about that after the break.